The idea is to minimize the amount of tapping that goes on, right? And so we call this tappability. As we say with all UX, test it with users, make sure it's there. But there's a lot of little things that users can tap on. Not everything has to be a huge button. And if it's task oriented, you know, then they can tap it and not have to do extra work, basically. So it's kind of tap efficiency. But I want to talk for a second about affordances or tappability affordances. Like, remember that an affordance is a UI element that invites the expected interaction. The one that always comes to mind for UX people is the Norman doors. You know, Don Norman, in his Design of Everyday Things, wrote famously about, is it a handle that you pull, or is it a bar, like a flat thing that you push? And that should be the correct affordance, because push is the physical force push, and the handle pull is pull. But then doors mix it. They go push, but it's a pull. And they go pull, but it's a push. And so he talked about that, and it's called the Norman door. And it reminds us about that affordance should be the right one and should invite the interaction correctly. Now, the hilarious thing about Norman doors in the real world is you get signs like it's a help strategy. It's usually instead of a pull, there's a handle and it says push. So on mobile, what this means is that users need to know what's tappable. There's a bias that visual designers have for making things so clean and so beautiful that you can't tell what you can tap. And so that's what we're talking about, is making affordances clean, but also clear, right? So that you know what you've selected. And I just wanna say that animation can really help with this. It can help invite that expectation and add that affordance. So the other thing that Don Norman talks about in addition to affordances is signifiers. And signifiers are UI elements. Think of them as visual nudges so that they give the user a little prompt, something that they can get a feel for. For example, a pulsating button. You know, my favorite one was a menu, like a hamburger menu, that followed you down the page on a mobile website. And it kind of pulsated a little bit. You know, and you want to time that pulsation to a heartbeat, really, is a good boom, 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 as opposed to boom, 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 which is going to create like anxiety or... So think about how you can use, you know, material design type of suggestions for motion graphics, or little animations or little moments of, you know, magic that can help increase signifiers. If you don't offer it, can lead to a lack of discoverability, false affordances, and can lead to user frustration, uncertainty, and errors. This is what the research shows. And the other thing I would add to that, you know, user frustration, uncertainty, errors is the technical term. How about feeling stupid? Like you're like, oh, you know, you don't want users to feel stupid when they're interacting with your app just because there are not strong tappability affordances and signifiers. Here's an example for you. Check this one out. You may have seen it before. What is the tapping object here? What should you tap? Study this for just a second. See what you think. Well, just a second, because you only have maybe three. It turns out that that virtual keycard thing is not tappable. The object below, the gray thing, it's supposed to be a button, I think. It's related to like a help strategy, but the contrast is low. Notice the contrast. So you have gray on dark blue or something like that. The other problem with this is it's sort of, you're stuck in this conceptual model that just doesn't work. It's like, what is a virtual key card? It's used for unlocking a bike, for paying for a bike. And they've introduced this idea of physical and virtual key cards, which is like, whew, way beyond. So there's a lot of things, you know, and like sort of stepping back from the UI and seeing, you know, you could make something really tappable, but it might be the wrong tap, a wasted tap, or in this case, yes, you're drilling down just to try and pay, and they're leading you into this, into their mind, into their labyrinth of virtual key cards. So be careful with making the right things tappable to support the task and animating the right things and using animation and motion graphics strategically